Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 10 in our series stateless2code.com WordPress. And I'm going to try to get the tagline to display here. So it's I'm actually going to want that outside of the anchor tag. Probably going to want to close that span tag. There we go. Let's see where that gets us. All right. So we've got that. I want this to be kind of under this stateless code view there. And I also want this to get darker on the hover. So let me probably just see what that does for me. There we go. Now we just need this to reorient itself. Looks all right on, I mean, not the typography or anything like that, but we'll deal with that later. So want this to best way to do this, but let's see what happens. All right. Ish. Let me start adding some class stuff here. So if I can get some margins. There, so that matches now. Up there. I just need to change the, want to make this all caps but smaller. Okay. make it uppercase. We will make it pink, I think. That's typically where I make the tagline pink in the videos. Let me see what that looks like. Probably want to make both of these somewhat bold. Font weight. Let's check the font weight. One down for each of those. I think that's a little too stark a transition. Make it a bit more subtle. So we've got our tagline. Oh, but it does not work for mobile. Let's make it smaller. Start there and see what happens. So that still fit mobile. See if that right, so now let's get out of responsive mode. I think that works. Let's take a look at our, see if we can finish up the transformation here. So I guess the only thing this will text on that, I don't think I need to have quite so stark of a margin there. So maybe I don't want the margin X to be auto on these. So this small padding 20, take it away, it goes right out to the edge there. Let's try that. Let's see what it does for our sidebar. Let's see if we can make this what happens if we take off the margin of auto on those. Go back to the looks like I can do that. Right before the absolute inset. All right. see what that does for us. Let's go back to our responsive view. That's all right. Okay. So I'm not in love with the typography of all that, but I think I could ship it as is with that. Then we can iterate on it, and then I do need a footer. Here we go, gold with a footer. I will go into the footer. And we'll start working on that. I'll create some content and stuff, and we'll see how that goes. All right, so I've got some basic footer stuff. Let me just go over what I did here. So I am not especially adept at idiomatic Laravel, Blade, or WordPress development. So all these links and stuff like that, I'm just right now throwing in the top of the file as PHP files, which is better than hard coding them directly in the markup. But there's probably a better home for this. I'm just putting this there for now. So we've got the footer item there. So I've got a legal div, and then in that I've got a flex with the icons for the Creative Commons Zero, Unlicensed, and MIT license. And then I've got a section with legal text, mostly against intellectual property. And then a social media section. And then that's what I've got here. Let's see here. And I'll throw in, just for the fun of it, because who wouldn't want to have Jesus is Lord and taxation is theft in the footer of their page? So I've got that there. I need to, so I've got some additional SVGs here, so I need to compile before I attempt to do this. So we have compiled. Let's see what this does from a. Oh, I have created some sort of error. Go back to the dashboard and see if there's a something I have is not valid here. Oh, missing semicolons in my PHP. PHP is not as unforgiving, or not as forgiving as some other languages. Okay, so that came out pretty good for a first pass. pass at things. Let's see how things came out on mobile. All right, so we want the div here. I think I want that auto and this one auto. See what that does for us. That did nothing for us on mobile. Let's go back to Tailwind Playground here. Auto. If I do that with the parent class, or put it outside of the bigger div, might be the solution there. Actually, let's see if that did anything for her. Not really. Putting this in the parent, maybe. Let's go back to our CSS. I don't want to quite go that big. Let's go similar to that. Didn't seem to do much. All right. So that got better. Our mobile situation is still all right. And then I just need to read some of this. Alright, so I'll at least do this, which will give us some horizontal space here. I just want those centered horizontally rather than left aligned. So item center and justify center might be what I need. This last one should also be I don't know if that'll work on a paragraph, but we'll find out. Doesn't look like it. Text center is the class I want. think I want to go darker green with lighter text here. Not certain. Let me give that a shot. Or play around with a couple things here. It's kind of ugly. Let's try the darker green lighter text. See what that does. Legal, I want smaller text. To actually have color distinction. Some padding here between these things. or margins. Enough margin. Also be text center. I want to make this a little bit grayer. Too hard to read. Let's go back to 300. Better. Let's check this out. Come out of responsive mode. So this needs a much larger margin on larger screens. Let's take a look at what I had for that big. So go to our item right here. Instead of left, all breaks pretty well. And when you get super big, it's not terrible. And there's some work to do with the typography and everything. But, and obviously there's more that can be done in terms of styling and stuff like that, but this is a this might be good enough to publish. But anyway, we have run long, so let's save what we've got. Write our message. All right, I've got my commit message. Here it is, signed, sealed, delivered. It's yours. Because I'm going to push it to GitHub, and you can look at it. All right, let's take a look at our backlog. We've got, these are both initial styling. Obviously not all the way done. But we'll move that to done, that to done. We'll call that done. We'll iterate on it. Improve comments, homepage about page. This is probably going to go to canceled, or I mean, I did at least rename the theme. I think we'll call it there.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.